So from their perspective, it's very, very easy. I think the key, though, is to make sure that they are where they need to be. If you go to the next picture, Michael, I'll show you a little bit later. So anyway, this is what we were able to compost at our corporate headquarters. We're getting approximately 8,000 pounds of compost per month. So we see a little bit of variance month by month, but I think it's just a function of how many employees we have, what the weather is, what they're producing. I think what's interesting, though, is if you look at the 2011 data, that's the green, that's our first year. The blue is our second year. And if you go from May through December, you'll see that the blue bars are lower than the green bars. So 2011, in general, we have less compost than we did when we started the program. And when I saw this, I first got worried. I'm thinking, oh, man, you know, they're forgetting now. What's going on? Why are we having less compost again? They've forgotten what's recyclable, what's compostable. But what actually happened is that they are so much more aware now of the waste that they're producing, that they're just producing less, which I thought was fantastic. Because I went to talk to your restaurant's our food service provider, and she said that it's carried over even to their operations that don't necessarily involve producing compost. So now that they're thawing meat, they don't turn on the water and run the water until the meat thaws. They're just much more aware of all of their actions that's contributing to waste in general. So I thought that was a really, really nice thing. It's been very successful. We've been able to save some money, not a lot, but again, you know, it didn't cost us anything, which was a great plus for us. And from the food service provider, they said that it was surprisingly easy. If we knew it was this easy, we would have done it before. Which, you know, I think is just is great, because we're still fighting this concept that it's not acceptable. So we did it at corporate headquarters in 2011. We piloted it for 6 months, said that it was good. Then we had to convince corporate South to do it, and they started about a year later in July. And you can see, you know, they're collecting about 10,000 pounds, which is great, which is great. At corporate headquarters, I've got 6,000 employees, and I'm collecting 8,000 pounds per month. At corporate South, I've got 16,000 employees, and I'm collecting 10,000. So I'm still not understanding why I'm getting such a big difference between the two buildings. This is about half a pound per employee per month. The other one is about a pound per employee per month, and I can't figure out the difference.
Your vendors in the South are doing better. Your food service vendors are doing better on their inventory management.
It's the same vendor.
But then whoever it is managing is the same manager at both locations.
They've got the same head manager, but then the local manager.
So it's the local manager.
But knowing the two managers, I would have guessed the other manager to be more lax, and I've seen evidence of it as well. So this is very, very puzzling to me, and I haven't a clue as to why this is the way it is. If you look over here, this is some of our next steps, I guess. You know, we do have some contamination. At corporate South, when we look at the cafe area, the cafe where we sell coffee and some other miscellaneous stuff gets very, very busy in the morning. And they will get so busy that they will throw their coffee grounds into the trash bin. Even though it's this versus this, goes here. So we've got some retraining to do, and maybe I even talked about just getting rid of the trash bin there. But again, I can't tell them what to do. They have to decide for themselves what to do. Same thing with over here, you know, with the rigs and everything, we've got a little bit of contamination with the plastic bags, a little bit of training, a little bit of reinforcement. I think we can eliminate that. But our bigger problem is with our food service return, with our trades. One thing that State Farm has not done, and I would love for us to do, is now to talk about it with our still happens in the back kitchen area and in the back prep area. I would say that about 99% of the employees that work at these two buildings don't know that we compost, because we have not told them that we compost. I don't know what we're afraid of. But we won't tell them that we compost. And we're not asking them to separate their compostables when they return their trays. So nothing has changed for them. And I think that would probably be the next step that I would like to do, is to talk to our associates and say, look, this is what we're doing. You know, we're having great success. We're diverting, you know, 50% more of our waste to the compost bin in Lexington, and you can help. You can help State Park get to be zero landfill. Will you help us? And we can start right there at the food waste. I don't think we'll ever get to the point where we're asking them to do it at their desk, but at least in the cafeteria, can we ask you to separate your, you know, recyclables and food waste? Again, I think it's more of a PR thing and perceived problems of what we think associates may or may not do. We're afraid that they'll just start stacking their trays instead of emptying their trays. Maybe we're afraid that, I'm flabbergasted sometimes. People will look at that and say, oh, you can't touch that. I'm like, yeah, you can. You don't have to, like, just put that there. It's okay to dump your tray like this, or dump your plate like this, or scoot it off like this. But some people just won't. Maybe it's that 20-60-20 rule. You know, and I think we're worried about that bottom 20% that are going to be not wanting to participate versus the other 80% that we think we can bring on board. We're kind of catering to the 20% who just would never do this and would say all sorts of things about it. But my next step is to now, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 other buildings in Bloomington that I think could be pilot projects for next year. So I've got a business case that we could save money. I've got a business case that there are, you know, no odor problems, no bug problems, no rodent problems that go along with it, and to pilot it now at the next big building. So that would be our next step.
Right.
Sorry. So we do. We try to get as much PR as we can.